Hello there, stampers. It's Jackie Bolhuis from Klompen Stampers. I've got a really cute card to share with you today, but the focus of today's video is going to be the border dies. I think that's what their official name is, basic borders. It's kind of a standalone set of dies in the annual catalog, and I think sometimes we miss things that aren't, you know, like part of a stamp set, or we don't see as we're flipping through the catalog. You only find them back in the die section. Well, I recently discovered them, and I think you're gonna love them. So we're gonna make a card today so I can show you one way to use them. And then I've got three completely different cards to share with you as well to just show you different borders and how I put them together with a card. So we're using Art Gallery as our stamp set. It's really a fan favorite. I've used it a lot and I know a lot of you have it already. If you don't, it's really one of those basic stamp sets, I think. Nice big bold flower, has some great greetings. You can do so many different things with it. And if you follow me, you've seen me do a lot of different things with it. So we're gonna use that for our stamps, but like I said, the focus is those border dies. Now, remember, all of the projects I share here on my YouTube channel, I always have a link down in the description to take you over to a corresponding blog post. Now, over there, you'll find pictures of the card I'm going to make for you today, as well as the other ones I'm going to share with you. And I'll have the card recipes for you as well. And what that really means is all the cutting directions, the list of supplies, and everything you need in case you'd like to create these cards. You know, that's why I do those videos. I love when you guys make the projects I share with you. They're intended for you to use the ideas and copy the ideas. And if you do, send me an email with your project. I love it when you guys do that. I love to see that you use my ideas in your own crafting. And then don't forget to send those cards. You know, sometimes we love to make cards, but are we sending them? Because now more than ever, there is nothing more like heartwarming when you go to your mailbox and you get a handmade card with a nice little personal note in it. So without further ado, I'm ready to flip this camera down and let's get to work making our card with the Art Gallery stamp set. Got some stamping tips for you and then those basic border dies. So let's get started. We are going to actually start out with the stamping part of it, but before I set the catalog aside, I just wanted to point these dies out. They're back here on page 162 of the annual catalog. Now, if you don't have one of these catalogs and you'd like one, hop over to my website. Again, you can use the link in the video description, and I'd love to send you one. Just click on catalogs to request it. But these have been missed. I missed them. It was just recently, and this catalog's been out for several months now, that I finally discovered them. And ooh, I think it's going to be kind of one of those standard, got to use it all the time type dies. So let's set that aside. And like I said, we're starting out with the stamp set, and it's called Art Gallery. Like I said, it's a great set for beginners or those of you that have been stamping for a long time. It's just this nice big bold flower. It's a two-step stamp and some great greetings on it. So many different things you can do with it. You could play forever. So we're going to start out first by taking our Melon Mambo and we're going to stamp on a piece of scrap basic white, our large flower. Now it is two-step. So with two-step, you can use two different color ink pads, or what I actually prefer to do is use one ink pad, stamp on scrap paper first, then stamp on my real thing. And then we're going to go right off of our ink pad for our second image. So look at how you get those two different shades with just one ink pad. You don't really need two different ones. So again, this is scrap paper because we're going to cut this out with dies. So let's just flip it over this way and I'm going to do our leaves with the granny apple green. Now, this stamp set does have the coordinating dies and I've pulled those out already here. So what I'm going to do is run over to my die cutting machine and I shall be right back. Okay, here we go. So there we've got our stem, our flower, our scrap paper. We'll set that aside for a little bit. And now let's work on making our card front, which is where I really wanted to share with you about these border dies. So let's see. Let's not put this in the ink. Let's move this away a little bit. Okay, these are the different border dies. You can see there's six different ones. And the one I'm going to use for the card today is this one right here. And then I've got, I think, three other cards, and we'll use three different ones of these on the other cards. You can cut a border and it can go, they're long enough so they can go up and down or they can go this way. So the ideas I think are just endless. Now what I wanna do is
cut out or cut off part of the bottom. This is just a layer of basic white, and you'll see why in a second. And I want to just make sure that I have room for my flower. So we can, if that was there, you know, we want to put this maybe about right there. Okay, so what I'm going to do is take this back over to the Stampin' Cut die embossing machine and cut that off right there with this die. And I'm just eyeballing it, trying to get it straight with the same amount of, you know, border on each side. So I'll be right back. There we go. So we could use that scrap for something else, but you can see, oops, I got a little mark on there. Oh, it's just a piece of cardstock. There is my layer where we cut off the bottom. Now, before we adhere these pieces we stamped, I'm gonna go ahead and I'm gonna use that granny apple green again with our stem. And I want this lighter. So we'll stamp on scrap paper first. And we're kind of making believe here. We want this one to come off to the right and, you know, kind of, so this one just goes over it a little bit. So I'm just kind of looking at it that way. And then we'll go ahead and stamp this one. And on here, we're going to put the smaller flower. And I want this lighter, like lighter than this one. So we're gonna stamp on scrap paper two times and then on our actual cardstock. And then the piece for on top of it, scrap paper one time and on there. So our overall shade is just a little bit lighter. Look at, we've got all these different colors with that one ink pad. Now let's grab our dimensionals and we're gonna put those on this piece first. See, and I kind of want them, you know, like our stems are kind of together here is what I was aiming for. So we're pretty close on that. And then we'll put dimensionals on the back of our large flower. Now this is going to be a layer that's going to go on the front of our card. So you'll see that here in just one second. Okay, there is our flower on there. Now, to make our finished card, I have a piece of basic white. It's cut at 4 1/4 by 11, folded in half. And then I have a piece of designer series paper. This is the granny apple green from the packs. We have the 6x6 packs of designer series paper that come in the color groups. So it's great because you get the, you know, all the different colors, a few pieces of each with four different prints. So it coordinates with all your different cardstocks and inks. Now, this happens to be 3 by 4 1/4, but I'm going to cut just a half, let's see, I think a half inch off the bottom. Hopefully that's the size I wanted. We'll find out, won't we? So we'll take this piece and back to our card front, and I'm gonna use our adhesive, and we can kind of decide, I think I want that print, and we'll use some adhesive, and we're going to, let's see, there we go. That one's almost gone. I might have to grab a new one. Let's see, let's go on this side. We're going to just adhere that like so. Now, I don't know. I must not be a very accurate cutter. So if this happens to you, even though my cardstock, I cut it at 4 1/4, you'll notice I cut this at 4 1/4, but it does stick out a little bit, you know, that way. That's very normal for me. Because, you know, when we cut things, you know, we don't have to be 100% perfectly accurate, but that's easy. I usually just stick it in my cutter and I will just trim the edge and trim off that extra piece because that, I don't like that when it sticks out. So there we have that. Now, remember our little piece that we cut off? I'm gonna just take that and stick it to the inside. So let's put a little bit of adhesive and we'll flip it over. We'll use the other side. I think that one's dead. I've been using that one for a while. It's almost gone. Let's see if this one works better. There we go. Whew, way better. And we're gonna go ahead and stick that on the inside. So right down there at the edge, that might need a little trimming off as well. So there's, okay, we're kind of building the front of our card. Now, just for interest, you know, sometimes I like things to be just a little bit different. I'm going to actually take my front of my card here where I've adhered this, and I'm going to come out here to 1/4 inch and just cut off an or 1/4 inch. So my front is just, you know what our problem is now that I see this? I don't think when I folded this, I folded it perfectly square. So let's Nice edge in there. And so now you'll see our front is just that quarter inch shorter, but when the card is closed, you can go ahead and see that other print down there. Just adds a little bit of interest, and then you'll see where that's sticking off. Now you can, some people when they have pieces sticking out, if they don't want to use their cutter, you know, you can also just grab your little paper scissors and trim that off. Okay, I think we're done with the cutter finally. So we have our card base ready to go. Here's the piece we made to put on top of it. So let's grab our dimensionals here. Now this is a pretty big layer that I'm trying to pop up, so we're going to use lots of dimensionals. You know, you can never have too many of these. And then the more you have, the more little papers that go flying all over your house. I think I find these every stinking place in my house. Oh, let's flip that over, and we're going to go ahead and line that up right with the top of the card. But now you can see our front has this beautiful border. We've got that little bit of designer series paper, but by having it on dimensionals, it just pops it up. And then when it's closed, you're even seeing that third layer with that other designer series paper on there. So let's finish it off. We're gonna use our standard linen thread bow. This is kind of my trademark on many of my cards. People have told me they can always identify my cards because there's usually black on them, and we'll get some black going here in a second, and a linen thread bow. And the reason is I am absolutely horrible at tying bows with ribbon. I can do linen thread easy because it ties easy. And I also like the fact that it's generally flat enough that when you add it to your card, just using a little glue dot here, it's not going to require extra postage, or it's not going to get damaged because you've got too much on your card. So I think it adds just that nice little special touch. And then black matte dots have kind of been my favorite embellishment lately. I like to use embellishments and add three. It's kind of a design element I learned a long time ago that, you know, odd numbers look kind of more pleasing to the eye, and it kind of draws your eye around your card when you do them in kind of a, some sort of triangular type motion. So there we go. Now we can go back to our art gallery stamp set, and we could add any greeting on here. And that's what I like about the stamp set, because at this point it can be, I miss you, congratulations, happy birthday, good luck, sorry, thank you, best wishes, you're lovely, I'm thinking of you. Any of them would work beautifully. So why don't we go ahead and do, how about best wishes? Best wishes could be great for almost any kind of event. Let's see, we need a block. You know what, sometimes I don't have enough blocks, so I just plop them on the back side of my block, and as long as, you know, I don't touch that because it's inky, I can still stamp it on scrap paper. We're gonna just use that black ink pad, and we'll take our scrap paper from before and stamp it on there. Now, this set of dies does have a couple label dies that come with it. These are the art gallery dies that we use, but I am not sure. They don't fit all the way. Ooh, they do fit best wishes, just barely. So let me go ahead and cut that out. There we go. Now we have our best wishes, and then we can put, you know, let's look at this here before we do this. I am not 100% sure I love that, because of this different edge here than this one. I think I'm gonna redo this and use a different die to cut it out. And you know what, I will do that after I finish the video, because I'm gonna pull in this card that I made ahead of time. Same card, okay. Actually, I might've used polished pink on this one. Look at the difference in the pinks. But here for the words I used, I miss you, I actually used the Stitch So Sweetly dies. And so I was able to have this one that has that nice scallop edge on it that I think matched that. So I'll go ahead and finish this off when I'm done with the video and use that scallop instead, or even just a plain. If you don't have those, you can just cut it square. But I think that looks better than what I cut out here. I'm not digging that one. Okay, let's set this aside, because remember, our main focus today was the borders. So there's that scallop border. Now let me show you the other borders I've used. So here is one with the zigzag border, and you'll see how this cut right there, and it's stitched and zigzag. And all I did was cut three of them. So we've got Granny Apple, Pacific Point, and Granny Apple again. Just kind of stack those pieces to get them right next to each other and use that on the edge. Combine it with the rectangle dies. Again, have that stitched look going. Now again, I will have pictures of all of these cards over on my blog post. So you'll see the pictures, but then I'll give you the card recipe and the list of all the products I used, because I kind of used a bunch of different stamp sets. Okay, this one uses our, triangle, whatever you want to call it, border. And I made this one very similar to what I did on the card I made today. You can see our base is all white, but then I cut a piece of black and cut that off, and then a piece of the designer series paper, and I just layered them. Now, an easy way, sometimes it's kind of tricky to get measurements. So what I did was my black was bigger than I needed. My designer series paper was bigger than I needed. I cut the edges, adhered them together to get the perfect border on that. And then I trimmed them to add it on here. So there is that one. Can't you see where you could use these borders on so many, almost any card? Okay, here we've got our rounded one. Now you can see I also embossed with an embossing folder, but look at the nice touch of white that it added along the edge of my card for a nice border there. So there is our Cherish Every Moment of the Day card. So I hope you can see how fun these different borders are. I mean, you could really use a different border on every single card you make. It just adds some great texture and dimension and, rather than square layers like we tend to do, square or rectangle. So thanks for watching, guys. Make sure you hop over to my website. Again, pictures, all the details on all four cards will be over there. And if you'd like to order any of the products I used today, you'll be able to use the shop button over there, add your stuff to your cart. Don't forget about my frequent shopper points. When you use my host code, you can earn points towards a free stamp set. I love giving my valued customers free stamp sets. And I also, as a thank you each month, send you an email that is jam-packed with some exclusive tutorials only for my VIP customers that order from me. So you're not going to want to miss those as well. Let me know if you have questions. I'll be back stamping again with you real soon. Have a stamp happy day.